Hello everyone! On today's video, I will be sharing with you tips and tricks on how you can start the jump rope. So basically, this video will tackle about a beginner's guide on how you can properly use the jump rope. If you are new to my channel, I'm Tricia Ortanez, 29 years old from Manila, Philippines. If you have been following, I always post stories of me doing the jump rope, receiving requests and comments on how I learned how to use the jump rope. So, if you don't personally know me, well, before, I used to be really obese. And if you would see me, basically, your reaction would be, maghahanap ka ng atsara. So, ganun ako kataba before. And there was a point in my life na talagang decided akong mag-workout. But since I'm time-constrained, I have a day job, at mas preferred kong mag-workout sa umaga, that jump rope would be the best workout for me. Ever since I stopped going to the gym during the ECQ, I figured na I have to remain active. So, basically, my goals are not just to lose weight, but also to improve my health and my stamina. So, before I give you the basic steps on how you can effectively use the jump rope, I will first give you a few advantages. So, this is my way of encouraging you and imparting you my knowledge kung bakit ko to ginagawa. So, first, it improves our balance and coordination. Syempre, as we age, just like a machine, medyo nagiging marupok na yan. So, kailangan natin ng activities to keep our bodies well-coordinated. So, if our bodies are well-coordinated, mas malilesen yung chances natin of involving into physical injuries. And as we always say, prevention is always the cure. So, second advantage for me is nakaka-burn din naman siya ng calories. So, to jogging ng 30 minutes, pagod na pagod na yung legs mo, yung ankles mo, hirap na, for 15 minutes, burn as much as calories kung mag-jog ka ng 30 minutes. Whilst also, this workout is very portable. Portable? It's very handy yung jump rope. Pwede mo siyang dalhin kahit saan. You can do it anywhere. Actually, all you need is a jump rope and a flat surface, flat space, ample space, a wide space para makapag-workout ka. So, unlike going to the gym, of course, you need to go to the gym. And then, you need machines. Eh, since katulad natin ngayon, since ECQ, mas madaling mag-workout if you have the equipments that you need. So, since jump rope siya, jump rope lang talaga yung kailangan mo. And, madali siyang mabili right now. Since ngayon sa Philippines, nagiging trend na siya, more and more people are getting into jump ropes. So, mas madali kang makakabili. Sa Shopee, sa Lazada, sa Instagram, there are numerous sellers. There are different types of jump rope na pwede mong bilhin. There's the plastic type, there's the cable type. The cable type is the one that I am using, and there's the one na talagang as in rope talaga. Yung tipong rope na hand-tied. So, meron ganon. I actually ordered mine, but it will be delivered medyo matagal pa. So, once I receive it, gagawa rin tayo ng video para magka-idea kayo kung anong difference using the plastic, the cable, and the rope itself. So, I'm not saying na mag-order ka ng jump rope. If you have something there, yung pang bagets, I mean, yung pang kids na parang, ewan ko kung Disney man yan, Barbie, you can use it. Advantage is it improves your cardiovascular health. So, what's the point of working out if it doesn't improve your cardiovascular health and your breathing? So, mas magiging malakas ang katawan kung maganda ang cardiovascular activity. It improves stamina, it improves endurance, and it improves your overall health. Kasi pag mas active ka, mas madali kang mas nagiging productive ka in all aspects of life. Let's proceed with the reminders before you do the jump rope. So, first, make sure that you are in good physical condition. How do I say this? Wala kang sakit, hindi ka lasing, and in addition to that, hindi ka pagod, hindi ka puyat. Kasi jump rope, just like any cardiovascular activity, it's strenuous, nakakapagod talaga siya. So, kailangan, you are in good physical condition. Second, wear proper shoes. Since it involves leg and feet work, mas maganda that you are wearing the appropriate kind of shoes for you. Also, workout clothes, kasama na rin yun. So, ang ginagamit kong sapatos is yung snug fit. Kasi prone sa injuries yung pa ako. So, isang factor pa doon is yung may arc, yung pinaka-sole ng shoes. Whenever I'm doing jump rope, mas preferred ko talaga yung Skechers na sapatos ko. The one that I will be using on this video. First, maganda yung fit niya sa paa ko. Second, magaan siya. Mas nakaka-improve ng activity kung tama yung sapatos and yung clothes na ginagamit mo. But if you are a pro at gusto mong mag-jump rope ng naka-skirt, naka-dress, naka-gown, by all means, girl, gawin mo yan. But for me, mas maganda pa rin na proper outfit, proper shoes for you to avoid injuries. So, third reminder is to make sure that you will be doing the jump rope on a flat surface. Bakit? To avoid injuries as well. So, hindi ka pwedeng mag-jump rope kung may humps dyan, kung may bako-bako. Baka matapilok ka, ayaw naman natin nun. So, instead na maging maganda ang first experience mo at mas maging maganda ang jump rope journey mo, ayokong maging last mo na yan because matapilok ka. So, my first tip, which will be shown on this video, is to make sure that your jump rope is of proper length. So, what is the proper length? Ano ang proper na haba ng jump rope na gagamitin mo? Most pros na nagja-jump rope, ang gusto nila is by the chest level, by the breast level, or the elbow. Ako kasi ginagamit ko medyo above the breast level or the chest level. Mas comfortable ako ng ganun, and since I am using the cable ropes, na-adjust siya. In mind that the proper length should be at least on your chest level. So from the floor to your chest level, both ropes na yon. Video pa rin, you can on the video on the left, you can see while skipping, my knees are bent and ang nag-aabsorb ng weight is yung toes. So, basically, kaya naka-bent yung knees para ma-assist niya yung pag-absorb ng toes dun sa weight ng katawan ko while I skip. So, while skipping, you can do counts. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1. Para magawa natin siya on a step-by-step basis, first, measure the length of your jump rope. Second, practice the skip. My third step would be wrist control and movement. Video, pinapakita ko rin sa inyo on how the wrist controls the rope. So, I'm sure merong mga gumagawa na talagang yung buong arms nag-twist, nag-go around ng ganyan. So, mali po yun. Mas nahihirapan tayong i-control ang ropes kapag gumagalaw ang mga arms natin. So, as much as possible, practice the twisting of the wrist na yun lang ang naggagalaw sa rope. Of course, also, don't forget ang shoulders. Dapat relaxed ang shoulders, less tense, and i-practice muna bago natin i-incorporate yung dalawa. So once you have practiced the proper rhythm of skipping and the wrist movement, we will incorporate the two. So these are the two major movements for the beginners na gustong mag-jump rope. So while you skip, you turn your wrist as well. I-incorporate nyo lang and then practice, practice, practice. Diyan magsa-start ang basic na foundation if you want to succeed on this jump rope journey. So, before you do advanced tricks like squats, running man, high knees, lunges, and yung iba may mga nagtitwist pa yung ropes, the crisscross, the side swirls ba tawag doon, side flips or whatever. You need to practice the basic skipping coordination and wrist movement. And my final tip is to enjoy. To be honest, ako ay jump rope kasi isa to sa mga activities na nakakapag-free ng aking mind whenever I'm very stressed. So, kapag nag-jump rope ka, ang focus ng utak mo is to properly skip, diba, para makapag-succeed. And then, syempre, we want to excel in everything that we do. So, ako naman, ang ginagawa ko, I practice a certain skill. And then, once na nagawa ko na siya, I practice another one. So, right now, I am trying to perfect the squats and the lunges. So, if you're following me on Instagram, basically, yun yung mga ginagawa ko right now when I work out. Enjoy your jump rope journey. Aside from the fact that it burns calories, nakakapag-free siya ng mind, nakakapag-distress siya. And I hope you can tag me on your videos and you can tell me something about your progress. If you will be filming videos, please do send them to me so I will be able to see how you are doing. If you also have other tips and tricks on how I can improve my skills, please do let me know. That is it for today's video. I hope you learned something from me. And I hope to hear from you guys. If you want to request other videos, please do let me know. And don't forget to subscribe and leave a comment down below. Bye!